This is David from Impending Doom, and you're watching BrutalBroadcast.com. In your face.
What's up, metalheads? Death Metal Dave here for BrutalBroadcast.com here at the State Theater in St. Petersburg, Florida for the Metal Alliance Tour 2012. And I'm with David from Impending Doom. What's up?
Nothing much. Just hanging out in the heat.
Waiting to play. This is the second day of the tour. So how did last night go? Where was that at?
It was good. It was in New Orleans. And we've actually never played New Orleans ever in our entire career for some reason. We play like little sub cities of it, so it was our first time playing there, and it was good.
Cool. And you just the last Tuesday, March 13th, you released Baptized in Filth. Mm-hmm. And so how did you come up with the name of that album? Could you tell us a little bit about that album?
Brooke came up with the title of it. It's kind of a metaphor for just what the whole vibe of the album is about. So we've always been a band to kind of put out lyrics and ideas that you kind of have to take a second glance at. You know, being we're a Christian band, we're never going to have some album that's just like, you know, rainbows and happiness and God is good. Even though, you know, it is, but I'm just saying that's not, we like to give it how it is and put a twist on it. So it's like, you know, you gotta kind of look back and look into what it's about instead of just looking at it and assuming, I know what this album's about. It's about this and that and blah, 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 blah. Right. You know, you got to dig into it. Because a lot of people are like, Baptized in Filth, are they Christian anymore or something like that? It's like, we're the same band. We're never going to change. But if we name some title, if we named a title Satan, you better believe it's not like, we're not a Christian band. There's a reason it's titled that, and look into the album. You know what I mean? We'd never do that, but you know what I mean.
So, yeah, you are, just so everybody knows, they're a Christian faith-based band. And I guess that comes from your upbringing as a child, you know, from your family and such.
Yeah, I grew up in a Christian home.
And I guess most of your songs are, would it be right to be based on the Bible, of course?
The majority of it is based off of, like, personal, like, day-to-day, what, you know, Brooke goes through or any of us as a band go through and stuff like that. The things we see in our world and everything around us, you know.
So you wouldn't say it's like totally Bible-based?
I mean, the education is, but it's not like, you know, no. Not like taken straight out of the Bible, you know what I mean?
You're not here like totally preaching the Bible exactly.
I mean, this is what the band's about, but I mean, we're not a band who stands on stage and tells you, you know, like shoves anything down your throat. Right. We're more than willing to talk to anybody after the shows or anything like that, no matter what. If you're an atheist or you don't believe in anything, or if you're a Christian, like, I love you the same, you know what I mean? I'm down to, let's hang out, have a cup of coffee, just kick it, listen to metal.
So, I mean, how is it going on tour with bands that are not so religious, you know, if you will?
That's all we do. We've done two Christian tours in 6 years. Everything else is, I mean, this might be the most extreme one, but it's nothing like out of the ordinary for us. Nobody on the tour is like giving us dirty looks or is mean to us. Like, first day, you know, hanging out backstage with the dudes in Dying Fetus, just talking about whatever. I mean, it's not like, you know, everyone's just really cool and everyone believes what they believe and everyone respects everyone else's beliefs, you know. Cool. We'll be right back.
you guys coined a theme called Gorship. Yes. Can you explain what that is about?
It was, Brooke thought of it like right when we first started the band, before we even recorded our first album. And I don't know if it was first meant to be a joke or it just kind of stuck around, but there's no really deep meaning behind it or anything. All it is our like worship sounding music that, you know, is, it's gore sounding music. You know what I mean? Like if you didn't read the lyrics or know anything about our band before and you were just, you know, walking by and kind of heard that, you would think, oh, that's a gore metal, death metal band. You know what I mean? So basically it's just gore sounding music. But, you know, this music's our, like, worship, so it's gore-ship, you know. Nothing right. Super deep behind it, but.
And tell us a little something about the Repentagram that you guys came up with as, like, part of a logo.
Yeah, it's kind of like the same thing, except it's our logo. It's just, it was a clever, catchy, funny thing Brooke thought of between repent and pentagram. So he's taking the pent from pentagram and putting it at the end of repent. So it's just Repentagram. It's like supposed to be just our little logo for the Christian pentagram.
I gotcha.
You know what I mean?
So what kind of stuff do you guys have coming up right now? I mean, as far as impending doom,
this is going to be like our biggest year for sure. We have a bunch of stuff coming up. You know, the album just came out a couple days ago. We're doing this tour. We're doing Warp Tour. We got a bunch of big stuff lined up after Warp Tour that I can't say right now, but it's going to be a big year, and we're going to be going everywhere, so.
So, on a personal side, what does David do, like, outside of the band? I mean, do you go to church a lot? I'm not trying to be, you know, crazy or nothing, but I'm just asking. I mean, what is your lifestyle outside of the band and touring?
Hanging out, playing. I still play music all the time, just in my room. I'm like a really quiet and kind of reserved person, so I like a lot of like alone space and time. So especially being on tour around, you know, 80 of the same dudes on the tour package for 6 weeks, like when I get home, I like for the first like 4 days, I just won't leave my room. I'll just sit in my room and watch TV or just relax, and just because you don't get any of that out here. But I mean, I hang out with the dudes in the band pretty much every day too. We're best friends, hanging out with my girlfriend, going to church.
Cool. That's pretty much it.
So
really relaxed home life.
When you're on tour, how do you deal with all the bands, you know, partying around you? I mean, do you guys get together and, once again, not trying to be mean or any, I mean, not trying to, I don't know, do you talk about the Bible? I mean, people want to know, you know what I mean?
Everybody's always curious and, you know, wants to know our motives and our band, so it always gets brought up. And that's usually the way it gets brought up, because it's a lot like we've noticed it. We don't have to like seek out because on the tour, every band wants to know already. So right. It kind of, no matter what, first day, people are already like talking to us. And we hang out with everybody when, you know, everyone's partying or whatever. It's just, you know,
you're not judging.
No, not at all. Like, right. We're just regular dudes, just like everybody else. You know, whether you do something I don't do, that's what you want to do, and I'm not gonna, you know.
You're not gonna down
you.
Them.
No, not at all.
You're just gonna do your thing.
You do your thing.
Exactly.
You know, let's meet in the middle and talk. You know, whatever. Hang
cool,
out.
Man. Sounds killer,
regular
man.
Dudes.
So, what would you like to say to the fans before we depart here?
Buy our new album, Baptized in Filth. You won't regret it. It's our heaviest album to date for sure.
Cool. All right. This is David from Impending Doom and Death Metal Dave in your face.
From the top to the bottom, thank you so much.